Hey everyone, it's Lisa from the blog farmhouseonboone.com, and today I am going to show you how we built an arbor for our garden. We just created a new garden area where there used to be a little cottage on our property. We added a picket fence and raised beds, and I really wanted to add something vertical to the garden. So first we created, in my last this week on the homestead video, two French tutors, and those are for viney things to grow up. And I also wanted to create an entrance. So we found an image on Pinterest of the most beautiful arbor. I scrolled through several different options, and this is the one that I really wanted to create. And there weren't plans, there was just a photo. And so Luke and I studied it, you know, we looked at it really hard and decided what we thought we would need for it, and then we built it. Now that we've created it, I decided to make a post over on the blog with all of the measurements and the instructions so that you can build one just like this without any of the guesswork. So that will be on farmhouseonboone.com. You can either search Garden Arbor on my blog or visit the link down in the description box. I'll have the direct link to it so you can get all the plans, because I am going to show you in this video, I took the camera through the whole process of building it, exactly how we built it. But if you want a more concise version and even a printable instructions, printable plans, check out the blog for that. You can cut right to the chase. I think that looks good. Did you get the little, I forgot about that for the list, but the things you're gonna put in there to attach it to the fence post? Oh, you did! I get it now.
Yeah. It's less than perfect, and I know you're gonna make me redo it, I'm sure.
The rebar's inside of here.
Uh-huh.
But on the...
Ooh! I'm just joking. Ooh!
Ooh! Yeah, so...
So I'm fine with that.
I could have just left that post, and I should have just got me some big old lags and just set the post behind this and lagged into these posts.
I like that way better.
This?
Yes.
Well, good thing, because that's what we're doing.
Okay. So we built these, and they're pretty easy. It was definitely easier the second time around. You can see here, when Luke cut this board, there was a knot there, and so since this isn't structural, we're just gonna leave that like that. Luke, what did we learn about building these? You want to attach the... Make sure you have a partner. You can't do this by yourself.
I can. I'm sure somebody could easily do it by themselves.
I don't think it'd be very easy.
I think some kind of woodworker could do it.
Well, non-woodworkers were able to make these, and I think they're really pretty. Oh, I know what I wanted to talk about on here. So the cost on these, because I know some people are gonna ask. My friend Sarah, that wrote these plans, they're on her blog, I'll leave them down below. She said they cost $25, so she used just regular pine, and that is totally an option. I wanted cedar because our raised beds are cedar, and I like the color of cedar. So the first day when we built one, Luke went down to our local hardware store, and they had these rough cut cedar. So you can see up close here that it's more rough. This one cost close to $100 to build, which is quite a bit. Now I think it'll last forever. I really like how it looks. I'm happy with it. Oh, and I forgot to mention that I even didn't put the top part on yet and ordered that from Etsy. So it'll be at least $100. The other one cost roughly half that. This one was just cedar 2x4s from Lowe's, not at the local hardware store. So it was a little bit cheaper. After they're both done, this one over here was twice the cost of this one here. I do still like the color of the rough cut cedar, and probably would probably spend the extra money doing them both that way. Now, obviously it's fine, but I'm just, if you're looking for a really budget project, use pine. Could cost as low as $25, just some pine 2x4s. You might even just have the stuff out in your barn. I really wanted to make it cedar and polished, and so I was willing to spend the extra money, but I'll show you the color difference. This one is just quite a bit more that cedar orange color, and this one definitely looks more like pine. It did save some money, but I really love this color here. They are easy to build, though. After the first one was a little bit more tricky just because we were trying to figure out the directions, but the second one came together a lot more quickly. I imagine if we built a third, it'd be even faster. We actually put them straight in the garden. I'm gonna have the plants that are planted here, there's some here that haven't come up yet, and then these grow up through it is the plan. Rebar.
Shoulda, woulda, coulda. I would have bought a little bit longer rebar, but I would have had to buy a longer drill bit.
Okay. Well, we're just gonna make this work. You are gonna bust your face, aren't you?
This is more of that. This is more like rock.
I mean, I put this mulch out to where I thought it should go.
Okay, so there.
But
yeah.
Maybe that's. It could be a little wider. Also, because I also thought because of this, it could be rounded out.
Mm-hmm.
And then also over here maybe. Rounded out.
Yes, definitely want some of that action.
I wish I would have put the gate right in the center.
Yeah.
You know?
I think it could be cool because you could put like a rounded out area here and put like a table or something. And then this could be landscaping. I don't know. I see what you're saying.
You want it clear out to here. Clear out to here.
The end of it would go at 3 feet-ish. Like,
from end to end would be 3 feet?
Maybe. I mean, that's just like an arbitrary thing. You can put it wherever, honestly. Because I don't really have any preconceived ideas about how wide it should be.
What about, is there anything with the gate? Should it be the same as the gate or something?
That might be something to consider. So maybe that should be the end of it. Maybe that...
I don't know if that would ever change. That would never change much.
It makes sense.
Get in here with the wheelbarrow. You don't want it to be in the way. Obviously, you're not going to make it any narrower.
No.
So that doesn't change anything.
We'll just make it in front of this post and maybe put it, like, maybe end it right here so that it's the same. I don't know. Just since it's arbitrary anyway, that's something to make it line up with.
Now what board do we put next?
I want to call them T's and I want to call them H's, but that's neither. Yeah, here and here, front and back. I'm inside helping the kids with something, but looks like Luke is adding on one of the top posts.
It's 20 bucks.
Oh, wow. So what are they?
They're just like leg screws, or they're just big deck screws.
Okay.
Like, I could have got lag bolts a little cheaper, but you don't have to pre-drill.
That's good. Yeah. Okay. I think it sticks out appropriately. Like it.
Yeah, I measured it. So.
Well, I mean.
I mean.
We didn't have instructions. Is what I mean. So we went a foot out on each side. Can you tell me the length of that top one? 65 and a half inches.
You say I measure from the top down.
Doesn't matter. Well, yeah, top down would be better. Yes. Just because ground fluctuations and such.
28. 27 and a quarter. But it's level.
Huh. How the heck did that happen? Just do 28 from the back and level it. Sounds good to me.
You mean for this one?
Yes, that's what I meant. Sorry. Oh, nice. So tell me how you created these points.
Oh, I just measured and put a point in the middle.
Okay.
I had it like this. Like that. Like that.
There's your point in the middle.
And then I just measured exactly the same down.
Okay.
In our case, 3/4. I just did that around the whole thing, but I don't think you'd have to.
And so then you do...
Because only one side will show. I guess I could I could measure it again after I make those initial cuts. Maybe I'll try that.
Okay, I'm gonna see what exactly you're gonna do after you measure.
It's just 45s. Actually, I made it a little more than 45. I have my that tracer line.
So you, okay. Oh, okay. See, I somehow thought you'd have to stand it up.
Yep.
Actually, that's all you gotta do. Oh wait, do you want to pick your favorite side?
No, they're all good. So you're gonna... I guess I'll ask you this when you get up there with it. Tell
I just,
me, is
I just
it
marked the middle?
So okay, it's 4 inches though. Like from the bottom, it stick comes down 4 inches.
Yeah, that's where my red mark.
Okay,
is.
Good to know.
Then I just have to put a level on it and make put one more zip one more strip. How's that look?
That don't that look right, okay? Luke.
Does that look alright?
It doesn't.
Well, let me go ahead and put the level on there and stick the second strip.
And so you're going to where the point of the 2x2 is 4 inches above the peak of the roof. Yes, and it's 4 inches below at the bottom.
That's it. Yeah, that's...
That's what's going on here.
That's what you're okay. Look, you can still see a little bit of the insulation from in the house.
Oh, from the cabin?
Yeah, I'm repurposing a little bit.
Good. Hate for that whole thing to go to waste.
We got one stud out of it.
Can you explain to me how you're screwing that in? Oh, just kind of from the top in?
Yeah.
Since the other, okay. Okay, and then I'm thinking another set of those, about 6 inches, the top of the next one about 6 inches from the bottom of that one.
I think it'd be cooler if we used a little bit smaller board.
Well, you do like the lattice work and stuff, but that's just like another like decorative thing.
And the lattice work is gonna be like this. Yeah.
Yes.
Maybe thinner?
Yeah, honestly, if it could be thinner.
Like, well, this could, if, I think this, it'll be about this thickness for the center.
Oh, there's a center. Okay, that makes
and
sense.
That's six, and then that would be the top of the board?
That's kind of what I was thinking. Hold it up there and I'll see. So we gotta pop off that picket and that picket in order to put the lattice through. That one was lined up just so. This one looks like it...
Oh, I didn't need to take it off?
No. I meant like it looks great now. This one looks there'll be too much space. Like you might have to inch over a couple of pickets to get to that same level of space. You'll see what I'm saying. Like now that space created is too big. It's not too bad. I just am afraid like a chicken could get through, or like the things we're trying to prevent to getting through will get through. And all you have to do, I feel like, is just move over like three of them or so. We're just going to take a 1x4 and rip it down into four down the center so that you have little 1x1 square pieces.
The 20 and the
yes.
10?
Yes. I'll mark the 20 and the 10. Okay, so we're going to do...
Let's go, I'll go to the inside and do that.
Okay. Every 10 inches, we're doing six pieces of lattice to go up this side. You think you can mark it?
I think I can handle that.
Can you kneel down and do that?
Oh.
Oof. That's rough.
It's heck getting old.
Luke's pushing 40.
But it cracks 40.
Not really.
It's 50 actually.
About to crack 50.
Right here for you. I'm about to turn 65.
Daniel's got my camera. He's gonna pull it out of my hands. Don't, Daniel.
So much for not splitting.
Uh oh. So you cut a piece 60 inches long to go down the front there.
Yeah.
Center it.
51 and a half.
So it'll go like 4 inches on each side. Pre-drilling the holes so they don't split. We learned that on the first one.
I thought these were non-split.
Yeah, they were supposed to be non-split screws.
I don't know if they're actually non-split. I mean,
these are pretty prone to splittage considering they're so skinny.
There's supposed to be no split twist shank.
Okay.
It says so.
It says so. Well, that worked for everything else.
I think it's because of these.
They're so skinny. So pre-drill, and you'll end up with this.
And then
this loveliness.
I guess I'll
don't pre-drill and end
I
up
should
with
replace
those.
That out.
Well, you know. You could put it in a less obvious spot, maybe. The whole thing. The whole thing will come crashing down. Nice work. Now you do have more of those, right?
The last one.
It looked better than none.
Cut that baby off. Don't let me forget.
What? Oh.
Cut that off.
Because I was just going to ask, are those screws shorter or you're just going to use your Sawzall?
I just drilled that into the...
Oh.
It worked okay on the other ones.
Oh, I gotcha. Okay.
But yeah, that's going to...
Just come by with your Sawzall. Yeah. Well, I mean, yeah, you want to get it off, but it probably won't though because you wouldn't come in closer because of this post being out further, but whatever.
For some reason.
You're probably right.
What do you think? Where's it looking to start?
I think just lining it up with the edges.
Oh. Like,
yeah, just the edges of the 2x4s. Right, oh, I didn't know you meant that. I thought you meant the length.
That's a good point, though. I think you're right. Because then you stare down at it and it's like it's going vertical. So that if they want it to keep going, you know, I wouldn't want to bring it out here because then it would have to grow back.
I see what you're saying, but I think you should put it in both spots.
Does that look adequate spacing?
Yes.
I think that's adequate.
I think that's adequate. Six apart. Now, we probably should have done a little math because what happens when you get to the top? Well, I guess it doesn't have to be one right at the top, though. As we feared.
The inaugural climber.
This would just appear as a ladder to children. I guess if it can support Micah, it can support mommy's big ol' roses.
Yay!
Yay! We gonna grow some big roses?
Grow some big baby boys.
Make sure to visit the blog if you want to build one just like this. There are printable instructions, so you can go over there, print out the instructions, take it out to your garage or barn or wherever you build and make one of these for your garden as well. It was a really easy project. We were able to finish it in, it would have been one day without the kids, if you don't have kids, but it took us, I think, not quite two. It really was a very, very simple project, and that even is with guessing our way through it, which you won't have to with the plans. All right, well, thank you so much for watching this video. If you are brand new to my channel, please hit that subscribe button. I make 2 videos every week on food from scratch, natural living, and a handmade home. Thank you so much for stopping by the farmhouse.